is capable of loving is a very special heart. And, you know, it's easy to find someone's heart. That's just what we do, you know. But it isn't normal for people who've never met you to go beyond and fight for you. And nothing about the last 9 months has been about me loving my child. It's about a lot of human beings that have never met us, some I will never get to meet. And thank God some I have met now that have just completely stood by our side. And it doesn't matter what the work is, you know, whether it's the phone calls, whether it's the messages of reminding me not to shoot myself, you know, and to stay there for Bianca, whether it's, you know, to make Bianca happy, remind me that, you know, I have to make her face good, or whether it's the actual words, you know, like Kylie, face pops up, you know, some amazing friends here, Sally, a lot of friends, Jody started with the social page for Bianca, you know, Tracy over here, you know, I met Tracy in our building, you know, 5 years ago, or 4 years ago, and then we become this close. But I want to introduce you to politics. You know, we hate politicians, and we're always I guess what I'm saying is we always have a perspective. You always have a very strong opinion about politicians. But really, I've made it a turnaround, because I realise that within politics, within senators and MPs, yes, they might not all agree with what we want them to do, but there's always one that actually is, everybody in politics are there for the human being. It's just that whether it's what our story is, whether it touches their heart or not. So for Karen, you know, this is the first time we physically meet, first time yet. Karen took the phone in, I think it was January, and from January, Karen has tirelessly worked on the Peter Dutton office, worked on every single way that she could to make sure that somehow Bianca gets this medicine that is impossible to try and fathom how our government is going to be funding for the rest of Bianca's life. But that's what Bianca needs. You know, she will not be standing like this if Solaris was not in her body. It's just that simple. She could not have made it today if we did not have that medicine for her right now. So, you know, Karen picks up the phone, she hears me cry, she hears me get upset, she never stops, she keeps pushing and pushing, and then one day she calls me up and says that she has achieved the impossible, you know, with the Queensland health system is accepting to pay for the medicine for Bianca. Sorry, my mouth is getting very dry, so I'm going to steal somebody's water. And what you have to understand is the feedback I hear from a person who works with Karen. And this is what she decides to dedicate to my daughter, is that in the end, if for all of the things that she's achieved in politics, if there would be one thing that she does before she retires, and that's to get the aid for this medicine, then for her, that this was worth her whole time in politics. Like, who does that? You know, these people. I would like to raise a toast to the life of my child. I know that all of you love as well, and I know this is hard for her too, but you know, all our children make all of us, you know, not be touched by this kind of illness, but if we are touched by this kind of illness, may it be something that drives us, not just for us, but for a lot of good people. I think today we know what love is about. Thank you guys for your love. Thank you, Adam. Thank you, Vince, for your support, for your love. I mean, he's not around at night when I come home going crazy. You know, I've had some bad sleep, so thank you, Chase, thank you, everybody. Thank you, Calvin!
Crates and crates full of jewelry. So what would you like to wear tomorrow? when I had help from Patrick Waltz, who is the fifth follower of All Saints. Tammy and Bianca don't live in my electorate, but All Saints is in my electorate. So he rang me and asked if I could help. I think All Saints is a great school. Patrick is a fantastic principal. So I said, I'll just send you through some stuff. So I had a look at it and I thought, no, firstly, Patrick's asking for help. Secondly, if this was my children, I would want someone to survive. So that's the process. And I know Senator Mary O'Sullivan's just been wonderful throughout it. It was a process that was just grueling for everyone concerned. And both Barry and I got to the line so many times and we just couldn't get over that line. And I haven't actually told you this, but this is how it all came together, Tammy. We have party room meetings. Tuesday mornings when we're in session, we're always in the party room. Barry O'Sullivan came up to me at the end of the party room meeting. He said, I've just spoken to Tammy. It's desperate. You need to do whatever you can. So I walked back up to my office and said, I don't have a rabbit to pull out of my hat. I have done everything that I thought I can. So I sat down at my desk and I thought, okay, what do I do? So I started crawling through who I knew at Gold Coast Hospital, because we've got Gold Coast Hospital with us there. And so I rang the chairman of the board, who I met once. He was overseas and unavailable. I kept going through the board and I found another lady who I'd been in the room with once. So I rang her and I said, this is the story. I need to get to the CEO. Can you help me? So she said, I'll see what I can do. Okay? So I kept crawling through this. And I went to the managers on the internet with the site, and I found a lady that I worked with 16 years ago. And her, when I saw the name, I thought there can only be one of these in Australia. Her name is Harlan Chattenbury. And we actually met working for forensic mental health, which is completely insane. So I rang Carmen, who I didn't know was working at Gold Coast Hospital. She didn't know that I was a politician, so I sort of walked to all that. I said, Carmen, I know this is not your area, but I need your help. And she said, well, actually, it probably is a bit of my area, so I probably can make some calls and I'll see what I can do. So the next day, my office, and I was actually downstairs at the time, out of my office, in the chamber, and my office called to say, Ron Carlin, the CEO of Gold Coast Hospital, wants to come to you. So I got put it out, and I talked through all the issues that he was well and truly across, and he said to me, he said, we can get this sorted. And I said, we. And he said, the anger should have the next I'm